In this lesson, I'm going to show you how to add a deployment script and the server configuration files to our project so we can use them to deploy our application on AWS. We're going to start by creating a deploy folder within our project. This is going to hold all of the deploy files that we're going to need to deploy our application to the server. So load up the project in Atom Editor, and then outside of this SRC folder, so in the root of the folder, create a new folder and give it the name deploy. And next, we're going to add the uwsgi requirement to our requirements.txt file. uwsgi is spelled U-W-S-G-I, and it's an application that we use to run our Python process on our server. So it effectively acts just like the Python development server that comes with Django. So let's load up the requirements.txt file. And at the bottom here, we're going to write lowercase u, uppercase w, s, g, i, and then just put two equal signs, and we'll pin it to the version 2.0.15. And then save the file. Next, we're going to add our server nginx configuration. In the resources of this video, I put a link to the nginx_profiles_api.conf file. This is the configuration for nginx, which is going to be our web server. So copy the contents of this nginx configuration file, and then in Atom, within the deploy folder, create a new file and call it nginx_profiles_api.conf. It's very important that you get the name exact, because we're going to be using a script to deploy these files to the server, and it's going to be looking in a specific path which depends on this name being exact. Paste the contents inside the file and then save it. So this is just a simple nginx configuration file. What it does is it says listen on port 80, and then it says this location for /static/admin, we're going to pass to the admin CSS and basically the admin static files. So the apps that we're using for our project, for example, the Django admin and the REST framework, they all have their own static files which serve the CSS and the JavaScript, which gives them the custom interface. So what we're doing is we're routing this particular static URL to the admin static files. And we're doing the same for the static REST framework URL. This part here, what this does is it passes through, it does a proxy pass through to our uwsgi server. So we're going to run our uwsgi server on port 9000 on the local machine. So all this does is it passes through any traffic that isn't matched by these URLs. Everything else gets passed through to our uwsgi server. Okay, so next we can add our supervisor config. I created a link in the resources for the supervisor config as well. If you highlight the contents of the supervisor config and then head over to the deploy folder, right click, type supervisor_profiles_api.conf, and then paste that in there and save the file. The supervisor is what manages our process on the servers. It manages our uwsgi process. So the supervisor will automatically start the process, and it will make sure that it is always running. So if it ever fails or crashes for whatever reason, it will automatically restart it. So now that we've created the nginx and the supervisor profile or configuration files, let's go ahead and create our setup script. Again, in the resources, I provided this server_setup.sh. copy the contents of the server setup sh, and then paste it into a new folder we're going to call server_setup.sh. This is a shell script, just like the provisioning script that is found in our Vagrant file. What this does is it runs a series of commands on the server that pulls down the project and installs all the requirements like nginx, supervisor, etc, etc. And it then copies the configuration files from our project to the relevant location. The only thing we need to do with this file is we need to modify this project URL to match that of our own project. So head over to GitHub and find the URL for our profiles REST API project. So this is the URL for the web, but we want the URL to clone so that we can clone our project. So click on clone or download, and then make sure you choose use HTTPS. Copy the HTTPS URL and then head over to the file and then replace this GitHub content here with the content of your URL. So this one is for my account. Yours will be the same, except it'll probably have your username here instead of mine. And then save the file. Okay, so now the last thing that we need to do is if you're using Windows, we need to change the line endings of this file. This isn't applicable if you're using Mac or Linux because the default line endings are the same that will be used on the server anyway. Line endings are just the character that is used when you create a new line. Windows uses this CLRF. We want to change this to the Unix version of just LF and then save the file. Okay, so now we're ready to commit and push our changes to Git. So type git add dot to add all the new files, and then type git commit hyphen am and give it the message added deployment configs and script. Okay, and now you can type git push origin. And what this does is it pushes all of the changes up to GitHub, so they'll be accessible to our server. Hit enter. It's gonna go ahead and it's gonna push the changes up. If we go back to our GitHub account and we refresh here, you can see that the deploy folder's here and we have our deployment files and configs. Okay, so that's how you add the deployment script to our project. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found this useful, and I'll see you in the next lesson.